I was just keep thinking, no, I'm gonna do this, but I know nobody's probably gonna watch it. So, alright, just give me a way to vent and let out my emotions and feelings and stuff and just say crap and not worry about people commenting too much. Except for that, whenever I watch it, you know, keep thinking that. You know that people know me and people that see me on a regular basis and just whatever, but I never really hear from anybody. I'm on Facebook, I'm on Twitter, I'm on Instagram, Snapchat and stuff like that, but I got people that follow me and see what I'm doing, because I mean, you know, you can have people that look at your page and look at like moving pictures, maybe they like it, maybe they don't like it, who knows, but anyway, then you really leave a comment verbally or video or whatever, and then you've got people that also have your phone number and know how to contact you, but of course you never hear from anybody, so not really too worried about it, but you're always going to question like the authenticity of people, whether they really care about you or really whatever, because they have a way of getting a hold of you, but you know, you never really hear from anybody, which is fine and whatever. But you know, I always deem myself to be, I guess what you, I always call a socialist. I like to socialize, I like to be out there and whatever, but maybe I guess I'm just maybe I'm different in that way. I leave comments and talk to people and maybe post videos or send people videos of maybe a, or a picture, even a picture, just to kind of say what's up. But I guess nobody else is really like that, except for the stuff you that I know I've got pictures from, like certain family members or whatever. But it is what it is. Now I'm just learning to accept that, you know, the genuineness of certain people. Maybe they do say they miss you or think about you, but of course you never hear from them, so, I mean, this is like one thing to say one thing to your face, and as they sit behind your back or act a different way behind your back. I really try not to let it bother me too much. I just try not to blow it off, because I know it may or may not be true, considering sometimes you only see them like maybe when you're in the store or going out and get something to eat, and of course they'll come up to you and talk to you, because I guess they gotta have that front that, yeah, I saw you and I don't want to make you think one way and walk right by you like they ghosted you out and didn't even see you. You know they saw you. Anyway, so they come over to talk to you, say hi, smile to your face, but of course, when they leave, that's the last time you hear from them until you see them again, maybe again, grocery store, out to eat, or on a movie, whatever. Whatever you plan to do when you're out with maybe your significant other or some friends, whatever. But, like I said, it is what it is. And I always question the genuineness, that's a word, the genuineness of a person's feelings toward one another. Why not really care about you enough to even talk to you or contact you in a certain way, but whatever. I really don't worry about it too much anymore, because I was fine without them, and I'll be fine with it, or it was fun with them at some point. That's why they have whatever number they have to contact me or contact the person they do this towards. That just kind of just deal with it. So, you know, I think the idea is that if you can always tell the people that are genuine because they contact you or they want to be around you or whatever. But the people that truly don't give a crap about what you're doing, where you're going, who you're with, how's it going in your life, family, da da da. But aren't really there. So you just kind of just do your thing and go day by day, and whether you have a 9-to-5 job and go to work and then come home, and if you got a family, you got to do your family things, and you got your time off, and then you got your social aspect of your life, whether you're on Facebook or Twitter or Snapchat and posting videos of what's going on or pictures of what's going on in your life. And of course, those people see what you're doing and maybe see it, but of course, they don't leave a comment whether you're sick or not feeling good or having maybe a bad day or even a bad week. And they'll pass by you just like one of those advertisements that you really don't care to see on your social websites. And you'll just click by them. That's why they look at you as one of the advertisements that, yeah, I don't care nothing about this person. Just click, 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 keep going. Keep swiping up, swiping left, whatever, swiping right, whatever the terminology is these days. But anyways, they ignore you, and they don't ever talk to you, and they don't ever see you. But, you know, one thing I am, I'm thankful for the family and the friends I do have that do contact me and post videos, maybe like, or even a little smiley face to, yeah, they appreciate what they're seeing, what they're putting, what maybe me personally, what I'm putting up. But, you know, that's part of it's hard. I feel it. I'm not gonna say I'm not emotional toward it, because I am, but, you know, I try not to think about it, and I try to ignore it, and then just remember just to do my thing and know that I have a family that actually does care about me and what I do for them and what they do for me mentally and emotionally as I come home. Their interaction that I guess I'm going to say need. Yeah, I will say, because it means my family, that I need and want. Just like you have a friend that you enjoy seeing, but of course, maybe they contact you every so often or whatever. But it is what it is. Alright, I think I'm going to quit with this rant and just eat my food and watch my movie. Later.